Greetings and various assorted salutations. This is another kind of start of the semester Canvas course tour. This is kind of just looking at the mechanical setup of the learning management system. Who might be viewing this? To be honest, I don't know. Some people literally watch anything on my channel, as I've discovered by putting up a video on paint drying. In theory, teachers might find this useful for planning out their courses or getting ideas of how to organize content. In any case, let's dive right in. So, right off the bat, this is my wrong course. We need to go to the right course. Spring 2022. But now, if you've seen my US History 2 tour, it's very similar. I build a lot of things the same way over and over. US History 3 is one of my favorite classes to teach. I just like the content of it. And we've had more time in department to refine its organization and whatnot. So right off the bat, you'll notice a lot of similarities. In fact, I copy and pasted a lot of the resources. I built them in US History 2 or a sandbox and then transferred them over here. One of the things, I'll talk about it more because I didn't talk about it as much, but all the course link pages are here. Now, one of the things that annoys students to no end is they can't click on Cold War and go to it right now. I've locked it down at this time because I'm still making some key decisions here and there. And technically, this is like 2 months down the road, and so there's no reason for people to be able to access it. And so it's written locked at this time, and if a student were to click on this link, it says this link is not available, and I get an email, which fortunately I've configured to go into an inbox where I can ignore it, because it's not a, you don't need to be able to access the end of the course materials date on the first couple of weeks. And it's, you know, but no, so I have a lot of the same stuff, the same submission processes. I really don't care how students turn stuff in. They can turn them in on Google. They can turn them in on using Word docs, they can use PDFs, they can use my vintage pre-COVID era turn-in box to turn stuff in. I just really don't care how it's turned in. They're doing the same work, it's just that it's kind of like picking which color a pen you want to use, and I'm not picky about the colors. So there's a variety of things that I'll talk about. I recommend watching both those videos together. One, to increase my video view count, and two, because, you know, the junk page is much like the junk module in my previous course builds. It has information that people don't care about or check. Yes, I know no one actually reads about their teacher. That's okay. I tell them about it the first week of, I tell them about myself the first week of school, and I call it good. But there's just kind of goofy stuff in here. There's what to do if you find a baby seal. I found a PDF somewhere. In case you're wondering, we live in South Dakota, a landlocked area. There's access to what if during work time in class, we listen to different kinds of music, like classical mostly. There's access to that. There's access to the train videos we watch. There's a story behind that, but I'm not going to tell you that. I'll leave it to your imagination. I've also added a few discussion boards. I don't expect anyone to really use these, but we have a recipe exchange where people can share recipes. This is a holdover from an ancient civ class that was determined to find the perfect pancake recipe. And so, quite hilariously, without any prompting, they started posting pancake recipes at the bottom of their assignments. Like, they turn in an assignment about the ancient Egyptians. Pancake recipe. Yeah, it was weird, but it's ancient civ. It's a fun class. Pity they got rid of it. But no, so there's some of these here as well. Some features I've added. Anyways, let's go back to the homepage and continue our tour. Now, right off the bat, the welcome module is exactly the same, the welcome course. The only change that's been made is in U.S. History 3, you take the U.S. History 3 pretest, the U-SHIP, as I call them. So that's the only difference here. But other than that, structurally, this course is the same. And that's because I like developing my own content. But I only have so much energy. And once I have a good idea, I like to beat it into the ground. So once again, that's another feature. Now, the way my course is configured, it is more work on my end to build. But you do not have access to the modules as a student. Because I just don't organize the modules in a way that makes sense to students. It makes sense to me. It's the way I organize things. I'll show you what it looks like in here, but it's not part of the feature thing. It's like right here, for this module, like I organized it based on sections of the textbook, 14.1, 14.2, 14.3, 14.4. Unit test. However, in World War II Part II, which is basically after Pearl Harbor, I organize it by resource types, lectures, assignments, resources, test. And so a lot of the stuff I'm doing is just not organized the same way. Likewise, I'm experimenting with this, and I'll talk more about this when I have an idea of it. But what I did is I made it so that the student choice activities for different units, you choose which one you want, and then it directs you to those materials. So that's kind of the setup here. We'll see how it runs, but I'm hoping to have it so that I can increase accessibility to my course, increase student choice, and streamline the whole process so it's easy to figure out in case you're gone. Is there more to this course? Yes, but I have a lot of stuff still under development at this point, so I don't want to get into too much detail. But basically, my entire course is designed to be navigated from the home page or the announcements. The announcements will always have posted what you're supposed to do based on what week, and you can always access everything we've done here. In theory, you could access everything we'll ever do, but you don't have access to it if you're a student. In any case, I'm going to stop here because I really don't have a whole lot more to say. And I've got some work to do in a little bit and a few emails to respond to. So I'm going to call it quits. In a future video, I'll talk about using mastery paths and whatnot. But for the most part, once you've seen one of my courses, you've kind of seen them all. I just get better at labeling stuff as time goes along. In any case, until later.